GM is an absolute disaster right now. Their dealers are overrun with trucks. They've lost 25% of their value in the last 3 months. This truck is going to cost you $100,000. And now the UAW is going for the kill shot. And things are about to get a whole lot worse. So I'm actually at a Chevy dealership today because GM just reported their earnings. And they were a beat, but the stock sold off. And actually in the last 3 months, their stock has sold off by about 25%. It went from somewhere around $40 down to sub 30. And I think it's because Wall Street knows that GM is in big time trouble and things are just about to get worse. So now here are the headwinds for GM going forward. We have the UAW strikes, huge, right? Production's getting cut. We have demand issues, both for their trucks on the retail side and for the EVs. And they are hemorrhaging money in the EV space, and it turns out that people don't even really want them. All right, holding the camera weird. I actually want to do the math on this High Country Silverado. So the price here is $77,000. And I want to plug this into an auto loan calculator. What you can see is price is $77,000, down payment of about 10%, so $8,000, 60-month loan at an interest rate of 8%. And that's if you have good credit. And we're gonna give this dealer the benefit of the doubt and say that the registration and all the other fees are only gonna be $3,000. And that's gonna bring you to a monthly payment for this truck of $1,500. And the total price after everything's said and done for that truck, all the interest and everything you're gonna pay right at $100,000 for this truck. So because of all these headwinds, GM actually didn't provide guidance going forward to their next quarter. And this is uncertainty, and Wall Street absolutely hates uncertainty. And this is why the stock has sold off so much in the last 3 months, because the space is bad. And GM's just getting hit by every angle right now. It is terrible. All right, you know what? Prices are so high for these trucks. Dude came out his shoe. I thought there was just one shoe, but there's the other one. So what's the story where you just leave your shoes in a parking lot? So right after this earnings release, the UAW actually hit their Arlington, Texas plant. This is a highly profitable plant. 5,000 workers walked off the job. Now this plant builds Tahoes, Yukons, Suburbans, Escalades, and it makes up 20% of all of the US production. So GM has actually stated that for every week that goes by that these workers are on strike, it cost them $200 million. And these estimates were before they struck the Arlington plant. So who knows what the amounts are now, but it's absolutely astronomical. And thus far, what GM has actually lost from the strikes has been a total of $800 million. So the UAW president, Sean Fain, just came out and said, you know what? They just reported these earnings and record profits equals record contracts. But I'm guessing Sean Fain didn't actually look at the earnings reports because GM actually showed a decrease in profits for the quarter. So the total now for the UAW is that 31% of their workers are on strike. And there's been another 5% that have actually had to be laid off by the companies because of the ripple effect, meaning that if one factory were to shut down because of the strikes, it might affect another factory, meaning that they couldn't get these vehicles to work on. So the companies just have to say, you know what? You don't have anything to do, so you can't work here right now. So now the current offer that's on the table from GM is that they're offering these workers a 25% pay increase, and this includes the benefits that they're already receiving from the companies. And what this equates to is that they could make up to about $40 an hour or about $84,000 a year. So as for the union and the strikes, it's going to get done. The negotiations are not going to last forever, and eventually they're going to come to some kind of agreement because production has to start again, right? But what it means for GM going forward is the cost to run their business is going to be elevated. And this is at a time when inflation is very high, interest rates are too high to actually support the prices where they are. So this is absolutely the worst time for GM to have to spend more money on their employees. So one thing that GM did tout on their earnings call is their ability to keep their prices high. But what we're seeing more and more is this at a lot of these dealerships. So now after the earnings, they said that they weren't going to guide, they weren't giving any kind of future outlook because of all this uncertainty. But what they did say is that when the strikes come to an end, they would actually give an update. Now, I doubt they're actually going to do this. The space is really bad right now, and if they did provide some kind of guidance, it probably wouldn't be good even if the strikes were going on. So I would not anticipate, even if the strikes end in the next little bit, that GM would provide any kind of guidance until the next quarter. And these are what we have been missing from GM, is these more of these four-door sedans. These are things that they can actually sell. These are 2024 Malibus, and the price on these is $33,032. So this is stuff that people can actually afford, and they've really wanted to get away from these four-door sedans because they obviously don't make as much money on them. So the numbers they did actually put out for last quarter, they were a beat, but they were in large part due to fleet sales and not an increase in retail sales. And I feel like we're going to see a similar thing to when Ford releases their numbers, but this is not really sustainable because we have this big pull forward in demand from the fleet side, because we just went through years where these companies couldn't get vehicles, and now they're ordering to load up their fleets right now. But whenever these companies get filled back with the vehicles that they need, then it's going to be 2 or 3 years before they actually order again. So I really think all this bolstering in the fleet numbers that are keeping these automakers afloat right now are really just a big pull forward in demand, and it's not sustainable. It's not going to last. So I actually haven't seen very many of these with Chevy. It's actually their base level two-door truck, and it's still $44,000 for just a two-door work truck. $44,000, that's crazy. All right, so now EVs. EVs are a massive, massive problem for a GM. They are hemorrhaging so much money actually producing these things. And what GM is finding out is that this demand that was supposed to be there, this craze that everyone wanted this EV, is actually not materializing. And they're citing that the demand for their EV product is just not there. So why would they continue to pump money into this EV speculation when, you know what, there's no one really out there that wants their EV product? But one thing I will say that is good for GM is that they're actually recognizing this. What they said on the call was that they were going to be flexible now with their EV production, meaning that if the demand wasn't there, they were going to scale back. And they've already cited that they know that demand's not there. So they're going to save a ton of money now because they're scaling back their EV production. And if, you know what, this EV thing starts to materialize, if the demand starts to pick up where they thought it was actually going to be, then they can start scaling it back up again. This is one thing that they have over Ford, whereas they're saying, you know what, we're going to be flexible, we're going to pull this back because the demand's not there. But Ford is just shoving it down everybody's throats, and they're wanting this to be successful. And now what do you see at Ford? You see Mach-Es sitting everywhere. You see Ford Lightnings that were not available anywhere. Now they're available everywhere. You're seeing that Ford has to actually cut some shifts at a Ford Lightning plant because they cannot sell these trucks. So GM, I think, is actually doing the right thing with scaling back their EV production and listening to the market and seeing what the market wants, because right now, the market, the demand, they don't want them. All right, so I wanted to find the cheapest SUV on this lot, and I found it. It's this Equinox right here. This one's 2024 LS, and it is $32,000. That's the cheapest SUV and might be actually the cheapest thing on their lot in total, $32,000. All right, now what's my take? So I actually put out a video about a week and a half ago talking about what I thought was going to happen with the earnings. Everything I said exactly happened. The earnings were actually good. Even in the midst of these strikes, the earnings were fine. And that's because these dealers have pulled forward demand because they're scared, and they knew that they would have to load up on a lot of these vehicles to be able to have them if they were to actually sell through them. Another thing that I knew was going to be good was fleet sales, because these companies have still not caught up with the amount of vehicles they need to load their fleets up. But because of this pull forward in demand, and these numbers are showing artificial demand, right? So my take going forward is that future quarters, and not just for GM, but for Stellantis and for Ford, are going to be absolutely horrendous because they're not going to be able to show this pull forward in demand from the strikes anymore. And the future quarters are actually going to tell the real tale that, you know what, these dealers, they can't take all these trucks that these OEMs are pumping out. And it's going to show that demand is getting crushed. Interest rates are doing their job and people cannot afford to buy these $80,000 and $90,000 trucks. That's what we're going to see in the upcoming quarters. So that lot that I've actually been walking on in this video is their main lot, and they've got a storage lot, and they've got all these trucks. There's got SUVs down here and then a ton of these fleet vehicles. Now these fleet vehicles, they're Rams, but I just wanted to go back to all these. So they have a small footprint over there for their actual dealer lot. They're not hiding any vehicles. They told me where the storage lot was, but just to let you know, it looks like they don't have very many vehicles over there, but they've got quite a few trucks here. One thing that I've actually not seen at all at this lot, both at their main lot and the storage lot that I'm at, and sorry for the construction noise, are small trucks. And it's very interesting because I'm assuming that means that all the ones they had, they've been sold, and they're really not getting that many of them in. And just to add some icing on top of the cake for GM's earnings, for the headwinds, for the EV problems, for the strike problems, California, in the same day as the earnings, just said, you know what, your Cruise program, it's done here, and it's because it's not safe. So Cruise is the driverless arm of GM's business, and California is actually one of the most lenient states for these self-driving cars, for these driverless cars, and their DMV just all of a sudden said, you know what, They're not safe. And they cited that GM misrepresented the safety of the technology. So the DMV figured out that what GM was saying about these cars being safe for them to actually drive, for them to be safer than actually a human driver, was actually not true. And the DMV is shutting the whole program down in the state of California. One thing that's kind of in the dark for GM that I don't really like, and I think this is actually an advantage on Ford's side, is that they don't actually pull out the EV numbers so you can see how much they're actually losing on the EV space. Now, I say Ford is good because I like transparency, but Ford is hemorrhaging tons and tons of money, and Ford's got to be losing way more money on the EV space than GM is, but at least they're transparent about it for their investors to know. GM doesn't do this, and they were actually asked by a analyst on the call about this, and there was no real light shed around the topic. So you know what, the numbers have to be just absolutely atrocious, and the demand is probably far worse than what they're even hinting at, because you know what, they're not even shining any kind of light onto how much money they're actually putting into this EV program. So this is a big problem for GM, for the shareholders, for the stock's value itself, because a lot of the growth that Wall Street wants to see is coming from the EV space, is coming from the driverless cars, coming from the self-driving programs that these OEMs are creating. And if Wall Street is seeing that, you know what, there's not a big future in the growth of this arm of the company, then that's going to cut out a lot of the value. And I think this is one of the big reasons too why the stock has sold off, and in the last 3 months it has sold off so much, is because the EVs are just not getting the traction that Wall Street wants to see from GM. So this is going to be a major headwind actually going forward for the growth of GM's company. Just a little behind the scenes on this YouTube stuff. I looked down and I actually thought the light for my audio, this mic that I've got on, was not on, meaning that I have no audio and I just recorded for like an hour and a half. So I was about to throw this camera into that field over there. That's how frustrating I would have been about that. But guess what? My audio's on, we're good. And hopefully I don't find out something when I get home to go edit this video that I didn't know to make me break my computer. And things are about to get up. I'm about to lean on that. 5,000 workers actually, 5,000 workers actually. Now this plant builds Yukons, Escalade, nope. And now Cruise is the automated driving. Nope, it's the driverless. Now, Cruise is actually the driverless car program that's, no, I'm not gonna say program.